I needed to calm myself the other day. I was driving along in the car and I was listening to a tutorial on a podcast, and the lady was extremely good. She was extremely eloquent. Then she said, "You need, when you enter these details, you need to enter your UAQ. UAQ. What was that?" Then finally she said it. She said, "You need to enter your unique awesomeness quotient." Sorry. That just stressed me right out. How stupid. Your unique awesomeness quotient? Well, goodness gracious me, before I go on, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Al Persohn. This is Life Lessons from the Crazy Dutch Farmer, lesson number 4, where we talk about good crazy, a good crazy man who taught me some wonderful things many years ago. Let me put up a statement about UAQ here before I get into my story. Here we go. Knowing your unique awesomeness quotient is key to getting the pay, promotions, and praise you deserve at work. Do you know yours? Do you know you deserve praise at work? Do you know that? This is a number that you calculate based on something that you give yourself to tell somebody out there how special and wonderful you are. A number you give yourself. Yes. Your unique awesomeness quotient. There's actually a website. You can find this on the wonderful interwebs and go here and you can learn how to set your UAQ. Now, I'm not knocking these people trying to make a living, but quite frankly, folks, I'm not into trying to set qualification numbers for myself. Now, I really hate those buzzwords that are out there, corporate buzzwords like low-hanging fruit, learnings, reach out, think outside the box, right? People are using all those. Sometimes you need new terms in the hard sciences, but a lot of this is in marketing and psychology and so on. I'm going to read to you a sentence that Jack Neff, I'm pretty sure he was tongue-in-cheek, wrote using buzzwords like this and see what happens to you. Let me pop it up on the screen here. Turn your storytelling into story living with hyper-relevant, snackable content for a digestible experience amplified by influencers. You know, sentences like that that are stupid. Now, down below, there's a comment as well. I'll just pop that back on the screen here and read that to you. Olga Kazan, not quite a cliche, not quite a term of art, but a buzzword is a profound-seeming phrase devised by someone important to make something sound better than it is. Yes. Let me go to my story. One day we had to bring a veterinarian on site. Now, I'm going to change Harry's surname to, you don't know his surname, I'm going to protect the family, and I'm going to call him Harry Martin. That's not his surname, that's not his name, but I will do that to protect the family. And the doctor, I don't remember his name, but I'm going to call him James McLaughlin. And I think that's very close to what his name is. I just can't remember, and it doesn't matter really. So who comes out to site? Who comes on site? Well, a young veterinarian, not too much older than me. I was 18 at the time. Someone who'd gone through school. He's now a veterinarian, and he's going to work on a cow. And he's doing some work. I don't recall what it was that he was doing. Anyways, he's down there working over the cow. And the story's a little foggy in my memory, but the lesson is not. And so as he's working on the cow, he is talking with Harry, and Harry says, "What do you think, James?" Now, Harry's twice the age of James. Harry's closer to the age of James's father. And James looks up at Harry, and he says, "Call me Dr. McLaughlin." You know, you knew this kid. You knew his dad. You knew this kid. Now he has to be called Dr. McLaughlin. Well, that set Harry off. I don't remember if Harry said this to him or not, because I was hovering in the distance. I think Harry did. I think after James said, "Call me Dr. McLaughlin," I think Harry leaned forward and said, "Call me Farmer Martin." And all day long, he was kicking, "Call me farmer, call me farmer." And while the story was a little humorous at the time, the lesson really sank pretty deep. And as I've gotten older, the lesson has meant more and more to me. Well, just need a quick drink here. It works like this, ladies and gentlemen. In the book of Proverbs, King Solomon says, it's quote, close to this, Old King James, "Let the lips of an other praise thee," or "let somebody else praise you. Rather than build yourself up and make yourself very important, prove yourself to the people around you with hard work, diligence, dedication, honesty, etc. Let somebody else say this is the case. Now, the Lord, in what I am certain is a very deep eschatological parable, does say something very wonderful in the Gospels. Now, I'm certain this parable is far deeper than my discussion. But anyways, he says, when you come to a wedding feast, he says, don't sit at the front. Sit at the back, lest you sit at the front and somebody of a higher or greater esteem than you is moved into your position and you have to be moved to the back. Now, that statement, ladies and gentlemen, is really profound. It's just so deep. It's as if the Lord is saying, and maybe he is, other people determine your value more than you. Yes, that young man may have earned the title of doctor, but Harry earned the title of farmer. Now, farmer is not a qualified title in the same respect. Nevertheless, Harry had accomplished things that put him way ahead of what the doctor, so-called doctor, had accomplished. Let the lips of another praise thee, or on the other side of this, don't sit at the front, lest somebody more esteemed than you comes and takes your position and you have to go and sit and be humiliated at the back. So it's much better to sit at the back and let somebody else promote you. Of course, as Christians, we know that it's God who does promoting and we really don't much care about promotion in this world as long as ever we are pleasing to him. Nevertheless, this is a great life lesson. Do the things that you do well, do them with diligence, do them with a good attitude and a good conscience, and let other people promote you, let other people move you on. Don't spend your time doing things like recording your own UAQ and putting it on your CV. What is my UAQ? It's a number you assign to yourself. Oh, I want to reach for my brown paper bag again and just relax if I could. Today's lesson is not very long, ladies and gentlemen, but it's really to the point. This has been Life Lessons from the Crazy Dutch Farmer, lesson number 4. The lesson is called Call Me Farmer. God bless you. Contact me. Like, share, and subscribe. I hope this helped you. There are more great life lessons to come.